DAX offers you a set of functions to create regular hierarchies out of parent-child data structures. The functions are path, pathlength, pathcontains, pathitem, and pathitemreverse. We cover all these functions in the same video because you need to use them in the proper way all together in order to create the correct data structure. And we start by looking at how the data needs to be structured in your table. If you have a parent-child hierarchy, you need to have two columns in the table that in this example are account key and parent account key. Account key is the primary key of the table. Parent account key is the key of the parent. So this is stating that 1 is a root node because it does not have any parent, whereas 19 is one of the children of number 1. The first function that you need to use is path. Path traverses the parent-child structure and creates one column that is named account path here. Account path contains the full path of each node. So the first one has only 1 in the path because it's a root node. The second row, 19 is a son of 1, so the path is 1 first and then 19. If we look at the third node, 24 is a son of 1, and again we have 124. The fourth is 2, that is a son of 24. 24 is a son of 1, so the full path is 1, 24, and then 2. One of the tool functions that are useful is pathlength. Pathlength receives as its argument the one column created with the path function and returns the number of elements which are in the path column. So for this row, pathlength is 3 because there are 3 elements, 1, 24, and 2. And finally, another tool function is PATHCONTAINS. PATHCONTAINS inspects one column created with the PATH function and returns either true or false if that column contains the element. So if we check if the PATH contains 2, you see that it is false for the first 3 rows because their PATH does not contain 2, and it is true for the 4th row because the PATH contains 2 here. Therefore, the result is true. Once you have created the path column, then you need to create a proper structure, creating one column for each level of the hierarchy. And this can be done using the PATHITEM or PATHITEMREVERSE function. PATHITEM receives first a column created with the path function, and then the position, and finally the data type. So PATHITEM returns PATHITEM on the account path, in this case, Level 1 returns 1 because it's the first element. PATHITEM 2 returns 24, the second element. PATHITEM 3 returns the third element. PATHITEMREVERSE does the very same operation, but it starts from the end of the path column. So you use arguments 1, 2, 3 with PATHITEM and you get the first, the second, or the third. Whereas the same arguments used with PATHITEMREVERSE returns the same element but starting from the bottom. And you see that level 1 reverse in this case is 2, that is the last element, 24, that is the second element, first 1 for the first element. Once you have the different level columns in your structure, then using lookup value or other similar function, you transform them into strings in order to build the proper hierarchy.